You're watching Capital Connection from the Illinois State Capitol.
Trust in American media hit an all-time low in 2016. A recent Gallup poll showed that Republican trust in media hit an all-time low just last year in 2020. A scan of Pew Research polls show several markers of an industry in decline over the last few decades. Between 2008 and 2019, newspapers lost more than half their workforce. Radio shed more than 20% of its workforce, while digital websites more than doubled their staff. Broadcast TV grew just a bit. Joining us now is a former TV broadcast journalist, Steve Stadelman, a Senate Democrat from Rockford, from our sister station, WTVO, many years ago. Good to have you with us.
That's right. Glad to be here. Thank you.
I thought we should switch chairs here.
I'm maybe much more comfortable over there, but you do a great job, so I'm glad I'm over here.
Okay, we're bringing you here because you have a very interesting bill. You have a push to try and save local news, as I understand it. We're going to get into that in a minute here, but I wonder, do you have ideas and solutions to do that, or are you in search of those ideas and solutions?
In search of those ideas. The legislation simply forms a task force to begin discussions. Let's identify the problem, look at the changing media landscape, and then potentially come up with solutions after we looked at the problem.
This is an industry-wide discussion that's happening. Many of the journalism conferences or different places you go will explore this idea, how to make local news profitable, especially newspapers, in an increasingly internet-driven society.
I continue to believe that there is big demand for local news information. It's just a matter of people being willing to pay for it, find a way to pay for it, and coming up with a business model among media organizations to make that venture profitable. I believe that demand is there, but there's a lot of questions about how you make sure that these organizations are paid. And again, the concern here is that there are communities, especially in rural areas, that are underserved by local journalism. And I think that has real true public policy repercussions when you have these media news deserts.
Is it just as simple to say trust in media declined at the same time and at about the same rate as the workforce? Or are there other contributing factors?
I kind of look at it at two different levels. I think you have the national discussion, so-called national media, where you have these trust issues come into mind. You have a very polarized electorate, when it comes to politics. But I think people have a different perception when it comes to local journalism, local reporters. That may not be true for everybody, but I think there's more of an acceptance that they're handling local issues and they may be more trustworthy. So I think there's two different levels of trust and belief when it comes to people and how they read their news and listen to the news.
I personally wish that we reporters, broadcasters, everybody in the industry had taken more a public approach or conversation to invite the public in. Once and while the public had started scrutinizing or questioning the accuracy of media, I think that many just said, let's ignore that conversation and just keep doing our jobs. It'll blow over. But it's a conversation that really, once we just sort of show our work, I think people can start to buy in at a bigger level again to see how it happens. For example, the time it takes to vet information is quite valuable. There was a recent study at MIT, I think back in 2018, that found quite literally that old adage was true, that a lie can get around the world before the truth can put its shoes on. They found that false information can spread online on social media by humans just as quickly as bots, about 6 times faster than the true story or the correction can ever spread. How do you weigh, I guess, the internet fuel in how do you evaluate how much of this declining trust comes from that very factor?
Well, I think an important component of that, when you have a lack of news and information at the local level, people will turn to social media for that information. And to your point, a lot of information on social media is inaccurate or it's politically driven, and people will weaponize false information for political purposes. And that's a danger when you have people relying on social media. And again, that's the importance of this task force and the reason behind legislation. Let's make sure people have access to local news information so they don't have to rely so much on social media, which may not be as accurate. And I think that will lend its process to increasing trust and making sure people get accurate information.
You mentioned political weaponization of information. That may be a story as old as time, at least in this country. Newspapers were quite literally founded as political outfits or campaigns to kind of be pamphlets. That's changed over the years several times, maybe most notably with the Fairness Doctrine, which went into place and then was sort of phased out over time at the FCC. Should we have a version of the Fairness Doctrine that regulates the internet or that regulates websites and how they publish news websites? What do you think about that idea?
Well, I think there's a lot of opportunities to access information, and it may not be accurate. I think the marketplace can best perhaps study this problem. Again, the fundamental point of this legislation, we want to make sure people have any access to news information. You can go to Google, you can go to Facebook and get information, but is it going to be local news, and is it going to be accurate? So, I mean, those are interesting questions. I think it's kind of beyond the scope of what we're trying to do with legislation. Again, when you have news deserts, when you people not having people covering their local city councils, not covering their local school boards, that's a real public policy concern because, one, there may be potential abuses and an inability to hold local elected officials accountable when there's no news coverage.
Yeah, that's an interesting thing. I think journalism students in classes examine this very question. You're touching on it here. Is journalism a public service or is it a for-profit entity?
Well, it's probably a combination of both. I mean, it's, you know, we're a capitalistic society, so people need to be paid and there has to be a business model that's profitable and successful. I think it's just the business model has changed so much from the media landscape, people are still trying to figure that out. How do you provide local news and make money at the same time? Again, I fundamentally believe there's a demand for local news and information. Just got to find a business model that makes sure people are paid for what's put out there. You know, as you know, I'm talking about the internet, people will read local content, but they've gotten in the habit of not paying for it. And that's the fundamental problem of local journalism trying to find its way so it can be profitable. So how can they be paid? The content's out there, people are accessing it, but they're just not paying for it right now.
It's interesting. The desire for media and journalists to be ethically, you know, untethered to some special interest always runs into complication. You're trying to sell advertising. Well, how do you have that firewall? Or are you a nonprofit that has donors that maybe not be disclosed to the public? That's always interesting. Do you take government grants? There are some nonprofit media outlets that have grants from the government itself. Is that fair because it's serving the public interest? It's something that helps American democracy and society function? That's an interesting question. Some get a little more squeamish at saying we want to take government money. This is something that's supposed to be truly independent.
Yeah. I don't envision a state program that pays for local news, right, per story or per article, right? I think it's more from a overview standpoint. Should there be a state government role in facilitating local news? That's a good question. I think that's what the task force will look at. Will there be public funding involved? Who knows? I mean, I kind of doubt it. But again, I think from a media watchdog role standpoint, it's an important public policy discussion we need it at the state government level to have.
You have an interesting perspective and vantage point because you've been on the side of local news for so long. It's clearly something you're passionate about now on the side of public service and public life as a state senator for these last several years here now. How do you view, I've noticed, I won't name any names, but there are a few legislators who have grown into the habit of going on Facebook Live and doing their own little mini broadcast or podcast. And I understand they have a message, but what do you think is the role of media today in and around government? Is it less relevant? Is it more relevant now? How do you view the sort of changing landscape and the importance of journalism in covering politics?
I think it's just as relevant as ever. And I think just the format that people get their news information has been changing greatly. And so that's adding some huge confusion. It's via websites, it's via the internet versus a print edition of the local newspaper that was more popular 20, 30, 40 years ago. People still want information, it's just how they're accessing it has changed. So I think the role still continues as far as serving and monitoring governments at the state and local level. It's a very key role in making sure our democracy functions properly and holding public officials accountable.
All right, Senator Steve Stadelman, I should disclose my personal conflict or a bias in favor of local news during this discussion. So I don't know what your task force will bring forth or that I'll agree with all of it, but I appreciate at least the effort to try and find a way to revive. Some call it a failing industry. I think we're doing pretty good.
Yeah, it's an important interest for sure.
All right, Senator Steve Stadelman, a Democrat from Rockford, thank you for joining us. And we're back in just a moment with House Democrat Lisa Hernandez, who wants to help teach high school students how to spot fake news online. That's next.